I just heard one of the most astounding and unexpected effects that plant foods can have on our body. It was from an interview with Dr. Michael Greger, and in fact he mentions one food in particular that if eaten the night before has these almost unbelievable effects the next day. So let's take a listen to that first clip and then we'll come back and look at a recently published study that blew me away. Could I ask you a huge favour? If you find these videos helpful, please do hit the like button. This hopefully helps it reach more people who may need to hear it. Here's Dr. Greger.
We used to only think that dietary fiber, which is the primary prebiotic, which feeds our good gut flora. Our good gut bugs eat fiber. They eat fibers of the prebiotic. They are the so-called probiotics, the live bugs themselves, and they produce, as byproducts, so-called postbiotics, like butyrate, acetate, propionate, which get absorbed through the colon wall into our circulation, go through our system, pass through the blood-brain barrier, have effects throughout our body. And so you can have people, you know, eat high-fiber food like rye groats or barley groats or something, and the next day have decreased asthma. I have improved lung function, and the reason is because then your whole body is circulating with these anti-inflammatory compounds, which cut down. In fact, you can do bronchoscopies and pull out inflammatory cells and show the cells are less inflammatory just after you ate a different meal the night before. It's because by that time, your good gut bugs have been able to eat these meals and then flood your system with it.
So do you remember earlier when Dr. Greger talked about those postbiotics like butyrate, acetate and propionate? Well, researchers at Stanford's University School of Medicine have just discovered that butyrate and propionate directly modify how our DNA is organised and accessed within cells, and specifically when it comes to cancer. Because they act like kind of molecular switches, attaching to specific proteins called histones that package our DNA. They ultimately affect which genes get turned on or off. This new research has discovered for the first time that these postbiotics play a more direct role than we ever thought, as they found that they physically attach to our DNA packaging proteins and change how our genes are expressed. The co-author said, quote, "We found a direct link between eating fiber and modulation of gene function that has anti-cancer effects. And we think this is likely a global mechanism because the short-chain fatty acids that result from fiber digestion can travel all over the body. It's generally the case that people's diet is very fiber-poor, and that means their microbiome is not being fed properly and cannot make as many short-chain fatty acids as it should. This is not doing our health any favours." But here's where it gets even more amazing. They found that there were differences in how those modifications affected healthy versus cancerous cells. For example, in normal colon cells, the fatty acids helped maintain healthy gene expression patterns. But in colorectal cancer cells, they disrupted the abnormal gene activation patterns that help cancer cells thrive. So this backs up what Dr. Greger has been saying, that the food we eat feeds not only us, but also our gut bacteria, which then produce compounds that can directly influence how our genes are expressed, ultimately affecting our entire health. Next, we'll learn the best breakfast for your gut, using Dr. Greger's prebiotic mix, which features those all-important rye and barley groats.